This video will explain how to program your microchip. So let's say that you have a project open in MPLAB, and you do a build on it. And it's a clean build, so you get a build successful message. So now you have a working project, and now you'd like to program that onto your microchip. How do you do that? Well, first let me remind you that I have my files organized like this. So I've got a projects folder, and I've got a Lab 1 folder within it. And I keep all of the projects that I made for Lab 1 inside that folder. So right now, this is for my Part A project. And if I go into that project folder, here I see the copy of the code that I've been changing using MPLABX. This is not what I want to move onto my microchip because it's not written in a language that the microchip will understand. So MPLABX created a hex file. That's the file that we want to move onto our microchip to program it. That's the one that it will understand. So where is that located? Well, you want to go into this dist folder, D-I-S-T, and then into default, and then into production, and then you find a whole bunch of files here. And one of them will be a hex file, .hex. So this is the file we want to move onto our microchip. How do we do that? Well, we open up this ExpressBoard memory storage, the one that opens automatically when you plug in your microchip. This is where we want to put that hex file. And it's as simple as dragging and dropping it over there. So I drag it into that memory storage drive, and it's now programmed onto my chip. And if, for example, I had PuTTY open, I can now see what my program does.